chill even the stoutest of heart. For within that darkness lies that which no one can control. And that something is me.
Hey everybody, welcome back to Out of Character RPG. Thank you for joining us, and you are joining us in the campaign, our Star Wars campaign, Darkness of Space. And we would love for you to subscribe. If you've been watching several of our sessions, you could see that we're having a lot of fun.
And we know you love it.
Yeah, exactly. So hit that subscribe button, you know, comment below, and just let us know how we're doing. Let us know if you have any questions. And so we're just going to get right into it, and we're going to do it in our traditional Star Wars way with our introduction. Here we go. There you are, John, standing over Vic in his bedroom, and you have your blaster out, and here in your head something or someone was telling you to fire upon him, and with all your strength, with all your might, you were able to stop from shooting him. And as you're pulling your blaster away from him, thank God you made that triumph rope. You pull your blaster away. All of a sudden, it seems as though Vic wakes up. His eyes just open up, and it looks like he was sleeping with a blaster himself, and he pulls up the blaster and points it at you. And he's looking with a concerned look on his face. He said, What the hell is going on here? What are you doing, John?
I don't know. I don't. I'm sorry. I run out of the room.
You run out of the room. And he gets up, and you can hear him taking steps. Are you doing anything else, John? Like waking up anybody or anything? Or are you just going straight to your room?
I'm going to Faluna.
All right. You run over to Faluna's quarters. And when you run over to Faluna, you notice that she was taking a couple of steps back, as if she was already awake, and that she was peering out of her room. And she takes a couple, she's stepping back as you come and enter into her cabin. What are you saying to her? What are you doing?
What do you know about this?
What do you mean, John?
Something was controlling me. Something was telling me to kill an innocent man.
Well, I have nothing to do with that, John. I just heard some noises and I was awakened. And here I am. Are you okay? And then Vic at that point comes in and says, "What the hell is going on? Why did you have a gun and why were you in my quarters?"
"I'm hearing voices."
"What do you mean, hearing voices?"
"Something told me to kill you. I don't understand it. I think I need to talk to Trent. Maybe he can clear us up for me."
"Kill me? Something or someone was telling you to kill me?"
"Yes. and it was convincing. I don't know why. I mean, I don't have anything against you, but man, I really just felt like pulling the trigger.
Well, maybe you shouldn't have that pistol in your hands. What do you think? And he's kind of like reaching up. He's reaching out to try to like tell you to give him the pistol if you can't control yourself. Are you holding on to it? What are you doing?
No, I do the Doc Holliday, and then I give it to him.
He doesn't look like he's impressed. He just kind of looks at you, and he grabs that
I'm like, you're right, I can't be trusted right now.
What the hell is going on here?
Maybe I need to be subdued? Abstrained?
Well, maybe you do, if you can't control yourself. And then Feluna says, that's silly. Of course we can trust him. He probably had a nightmare of some sort.
No, it felt so good to want to kill him. You don't understand. Can't be trusted right now.
Now, all of you are hearing this commotion because, you know, it's the middle of the night. So if you guys want to get up and move and walk over to find out what the heck is going on, you're entitled to do that. Is that what you're doing?
Yeah, I get up in my pajamas and start walking over.
Take your pajamas.
I'm right. The captain's.
M1K3, are you also doing that? You're going over there, you hear this commotion.
I'm also on my pajamas, but I'm asleep.
Well, let me sleep.
I know you don't, yeah. And Trenton, are you going over there?
Yeah, I'm going over there.
All right, so all of you are there. And it seems as though something's going on. There's some worried looks on everybody's faces. So what are you saying, John?
Trenton, you have to help me. I don't know what the heck is going on. I almost killed Vic. It wasn't my decision. Something was telling me to do it, and it was convincing. I felt like if I didn't pull everything I had into that roll to triumph, I would have shot him for certain.
I put my hand on his shoulder like a father would do his son, and I hug him. And I say, don't worry, we'll get through this. We'll figure it out. Only understanding the facts can help you. And I look over at Feluna, and I'm like, fact number one, she's bad. That's what I say. And I'm like,
Feluna says, what? Fact number two. I'm done with this. I'm going back to my quarters. I don't have time for this nonsense.
Oh, I thought you were going to leave the ship.
That doesn't make sense, Lance, being that we are in hyperspace right now.
You're the one that said you were leaving.
I mean, said I'm leaving to my quarters.
Oh, your quarters. Okay. Pardon my expression.
And she just kind of like doesn't listen and kind of just walks right off.
Now that she's gone, I'm like, John, what did she say to you? What happened?
She says she didn't have anything to do with it. It doesn't sound like a female's voice. It sounds like...
Well, what I'm saying is, what happened exactly? A voice went in your head?
Yeah, something was like, just do it. I woke up and I was in his room already. Sort of like I was in a trance. I can't be trusted. You have to handcuff me.
No.
I handcuff him.
All right.
I'm like, thank you, Mike. Excuse me. Understands. He's not clouded by.
All right. So M1K3, you go over and you handcuff him, you restrain him, and Vic says, "I think that's the best idea, especially if he's admitting that he can't control himself. At least temporarily, that'll be best until we get to Tatooine. I need to get to Tatooine." I know a bioengineer there that can examine and look at these vials, find out exactly what they are. Also, I need to replenish some equipment. I also have a connection there, a chop shop. We can go there and purchase some items we might need.
Is there any a doctor I can see? My left arm is badly injured.
And I have a sprain.
Yes, the bioengineer. He'll be able to help you some with that. So I believe he can help you with that. It'll be good if we go to see G-Bar. His name is G-Bar.
Okay.
All right.
I stay with John.
Anybody else wanting to do anything else? You notice that Vic goes back to his quarters. And what are you guys doing? Are you just going to go back to sleep? Are you going to just... anything in particular?
Yeah, I don't want to go right back to sleep yet. I want to make sure. I want to see how many days it takes to get to Tatooine.
Yeah, it's going to take you by it's only a day's travel.
Oh, all right.
Before I go back to bed, well, I'm not going to go back to bed, obviously, because John is distraught, so I want to stay with him. But how far did I get with my lightsaber damage, and did I figure it out, or how badly?
Yeah, being that you were sleeping, you weren't working on that, but on the next day, I mean, unless you want to work on it all night, there are some equipment that you're going to need. You might be able to get that equipment that's necessary to repair it fully. To replace the parts that are not working right now, but you won't be able to do that while you're on the ship.
Okay. That's all I need to know.
Anybody else want to do anything?
I just want to say that I don't know about you guys, but him being locked up and her, and there's like a lot of mystery here. I mean, she's in her quarters, and he's locked up where? In his room?
Vic? Me?
Yes.
I'm talking about John.
I'm with Mike.
Oh, I thought you handcuffed him.
Trenton is staying in our area.
All right. Yeah, I'm not exactly going to sleep yet. I don't feel comfortable about what you just told me. John just told me.
He'll be okay.
I don't know. That's what you say, but he said that he almost killed this guy. So, I'm gonna stay awake.
I understand the force. We'll be fine.
All right. So, Lance, you're staying awake. John, you're handcuffed. I take you're falling asleep, even though you're handcuffed. Correct. You're gonna get your rest.
Yeah, I lean up against Mike.
Okay, no problem. Trenton, I take you going back to bed?
Yeah.
Okay, and M1, K3, you're just monitoring John, correct?
Yep.
Okay, so you guys continue flying for several hours. It's the next day. You start to hear that beeping sound signifying that you are going to be coming out of hyperspace, that you have reached your destination of Tatooine. I do need, being that Lance, you didn't fall asleep at all, I'm going to need you to make a roll to see if you're going to get a negative or if you were able to kind of like overcome that.
Okay. You got your 8 hours.
Drink some space coffee.
I'm going to drink some of those Maya or whatever you call them. They should give me some.
All right, I want you to roll a resilience roll, right? Ooh, so that's on the brawn. Resilience.
No,
if you have the ability, you're going to make that roll. That's the roll you'll make whenever you go without sleep.
Here goes nothing. I cancel myself out.
All right.
So I guess that means I didn't succeed, I guess.
That's exactly what that means. So, Lance, because you haven't had any sleep, everything that you do is going to be with a setback die. So that's on top of any other setback dice that I may give you because of scenarios. Because you're just exhausted. So you have one setback black die every time you do anything. You make any kind of
roll. You just got bags in your eyes.
Yeah. I'll ask that biomedical doctor if he has any drugs when we get there.
You want to go on drugs too now?
Just a quick upper.
Yeah, it's always quick.
I'm just gonna give you a Viagra.
That might get me in trouble. Then I'll be after what's her name?
Fiona.
Fiona, come here. You're looking pretty good.
you're at Tatooine. And where are you going to land your vessel? Are you going to do your usual spaceport 93?
No, I thought they got blown up.
No. All right. So you fly and you land your vessel at the another spaceport. Spaceport 122. Spaceport 122. Okay, and when you go through 122, you start to head, and also everybody's getting ready to get off the vessel. Vic is there, and he says he needs to go to his connection. Are you guys going to follow him? Yes. Feluna says she would like to go with you guys also, if possible. What are you guys saying to her?
I'm not saying a word to her. But yeah,
I have no comments. She can come if she wants.
So all of you are heading towards the bio lab, and you go through the city.
Hey, this looks familiar.
Yeah, the city of Mos Eisley's, right? And it's very crowded. There's a lot of commotions going on. People chattering, people making sales. People looking for bounty on other heads of different people. There's a lot of commotions going on. And Vic is taking you through some of the seedier parts of Mos Eisley. It looks like this is a place where maybe some smuggling is done. And it makes sense being that the rebels have to kind of like hide and being taken care of. And you finally get to... So you enter a small bioengineering lab, and you see that the place is cluttered with electronics. You can see your microscopes all over the place, robotics. You see some power generators, papers. There's like hazardous material all over the place, chemicals, vials, test tubes. And you see this small figure kind of come around from some machinery. And it's this small alien looking with these kind of popped out eyes, and he looks at you, and right away he kind of has a concerned look at his face, but then as soon as he sees Vic, his eyes get a little bit softer, and you hear
him say, "Hey, Vic!
And you could tell he's very excited, and Vic kind of like puts a smile on his face and kind of like even pats him on his head as if he's like a little child, but he's not a little child, right? And Vic kind of looks at him and he says, G-Bar, I need your help. I need your help with this. And he pulls out the vials, right? And you notice that his eyes kind of even get larger than they are, right? G-Bar, his eyes kind of like even get bigger. Like he's excited, like what the hell is this? And as he looks at it, you even hear him say,
what's this Vic, what'd you bring me? This is exciting. This is interesting.
And he's kind of like looking at, he's turning the tubes around and all about, and Vic says, well, that's why I brought it for you to figure out for me, my friend. Can you tell me what this is? Because I think it's quite important. And he looks at Vic and he says,
oh, yes, G-Bar can find out. G-Bar knows many things. Let G-Bar figure this out. Loves puzzles. I do love puzzles. Oh, yes.
And he brings it over to a microscope, and he throws one of the tubes. This opening opens up, and he throws the tube in there, and it seals, and the screen goes on, and he starts to look at the molecules, and you can see some molecules changing there, and his eyes just kind of like blow up as he's watching this, and he's looking at it. And you could tell he's even like rubbing his chin there.
While he's busy with that, can I steal something? Like, does he have anything like really valuable?
Yeah, there's a whole bunch of different test tubes there. There's different experiments you could tell that he's doing. He's got some medical gear there to help you guys. Things like that, but nothing like extremely expensive. If that's what are you looking for?
So you have like a, you know how the mechanics, the robots have a medipack for themselves. I don't know what it's called, but it's, you know what I'm talking about.
You do notice that there's some machinery there because he's a bioengineer, so he can hook machinery onto people, cybernetics and stuff like that. So you do see some important or expensive equipment there. Arts. That has to do with bioengineering and stuff like that.
All right, so I'm gonna grab that and just act like it's like I came in with it.
All right. So you're robbing the poor guy as he's helping you. It sounds wonderful, right? So he's looking into this and he's like rubbing his chin. He's excited and he says,
"Midichlorians! Midichlorians, yes! These are yes, midichlorians, life forms that live symbiotically with us inside the cells of all human things. Yes, but very strange. These are unique. These are different. I've seen them before. Very rare, these are. These are quite large. Larger than the normal ones I've seen before. But then again, Jibar hasn't seen too many, you must understand. But these are strange."
So he looks enthralled, and Vic says to him, "Strange? Like, besides the sides, what else is strange about it? Are you guys asking him anything in particular?"
As you know.
Huh? Yes, I do ask him really quick. How do you know about midichlorians in the Force?
Midichlorians, yes. We know in science. Very important. Because midichlorians are life forms. So scientists like me, we know about them. But they are not the Force, remember. They are linked to the potential of the Force in many different living beings. But the Force is everywhere, from my understanding. Of course, I'm not specialized in Force. I'm not a Jedi. Are you Jedi?
No.
I smile. You got a couple in here.
Are you claiming you're a Jedi? Oh, okay.
No, we have a couple in here. That's all.
Oh. Jedi you are? Couple of Jedi? Wow. It's a... amazing! I've never met Jedi before. This is exciting! Yes! Oh, Vic, you bring Jedi's here! I'm so thrilled! G-Bot,
I have a question about midichlorians.
What are you asking him?
Is there a difference between the midichlorians of the dark side users and the light side?
Good question.
G-Bot does not know answer to that. My understanding, midichlorians are life forms that just connect the power of the Force. But I do not know if one type of midichlorian would be with one type of Jedi or Sith. I do not know that. I'm sorry, G-Bar does not know that much about the Force.
Have you had anybody else come through your lab in regards to midichlorians besides us?
Not at all. That is why G-Bar is so excited. So excited G-Bar is. I love this.
I just look at him with loathe because I don't really like aliens.
That's good. I mean, you do that, and you notice as he's getting excited, he's clapping his hands, and he kind of like looks up at you like with a smile. And then he notices that you're like looking at him, kind of like that.
I'm serious.
He kind of like stops and kind of.
Jibar, do not be afraid. He's just a little racist. I put John's hands out on like cause I have it like this. I put it on the table. I'm like, Jibar, can you take some blood or melichlorians from John and see the difference?
Wait, what?
Is this one called John? Is he okay to come close to? You have him handcuffed. G-Bar does not mix with criminals. Well, that's a lie. G-Bar does mix with criminals. But not criminals that are chained up.
He's fine. I do have another question. I know if we're flooding you with a lot of questions. I do have one more.
What's the question possible. You're asking?
What if someone, let's say a force user, would drink that? What would happen?
Oh. G-Bar would not really know, but one thing, as a scientist, I would say, as a bioengineer, this amount of midichlorians is quite a lot. Never seen this much. And if one individual who can maybe house this many midichlorians with the force in their system, they would have... this is assumption now. They would have great power of the force. Extreme power of the force. G-Bar would like to see it. Do you plan to drink it?
No, you're not.
Hey, what would happen if you're not, if you don't have the force and you drink it?
Oh, G-Bar would assume one who cannot house and maintain such power. Who knows what might happen? One might explode, maybe? One cells might deteriorate? One... G-Bar does not know! Do you wish to drink it so I can analyze?
No, but I have a sprained leg and Mr. G-Bar, and I need it peeled. And I need something to keep me awake. Looks like you got that around here somewhere.
G-Bar.
Try one of those cannons.
In my head, I'm saying.
G-Bar could fix your leg. Yes, G-Bar, tend to that in a moment. More exciting things happening here than the sprained leg.
I'm just thinking about him. I'm like this insect. Ugh.
If you want to do your experiment, since my left arm is extreme pain, if I take just a little bit of that midichlorians, just a little bit, to see what would happen, you could experiment on me.
Oh, yes! G-Bar is excited to do experiments such as that. If Trenton allows him, I would like to observe and monitor, and I'll take care of you, I promise.
Absolutely.
Just put a little arsenic in it, too, while you're at it.
Arsenic? Oh, wow. Lance!
Alright, Trenton, are you going to be drinking one of the vials?
Does Vic look like he's okay with this?
Yeah, you look at Vic. Vic is kind of like, he's kind of interested too to find out. He says, you hear Vic, he says, two of these I am taking back to the rebels. So
that's fine.
It is fine because you can find out what you have to find out, G-Bar, and I can bring that information back with me to the Rebel Alliance. So,
why is he taking two? That wasn't the deal.
what do you mean, M1K3?
You only need one to analyze or to do what you wish with the rebels.
That's true, I do. But what are you planning to do with the other vial if I was to leave it?
We need one to go to... Where are you taking it to, Steven?
What? I'm not.
I forgot what you said. You was taking it somewhere, right? To the Jedi? Temple. One's going to the Jedi Temple, and then one is going with me to sell on the black market. We need payment. We cannot live off of freedom.
Wait, let me understand this, M1K3. You want me to take one of these vials that might be crucial and let you just put it out there on the black market? Is this what you're telling me? And you think this is wise to do?
Well, I'm going to intercede. Well, that's not kind of what he means. What he means is, like, he's going to maybe use it as leverage, but he's really not. He's going to use it, maybe we can use it on the ship to fix up the ship, you know, to help the Rebel cause. I'm just making up some big story. To help the Rebel cause, you know, and and defeat the Empire once and for all. That's actually the truth, that part.
So make a deception roll. And
Come on, Lance. Come on, Lance.
Difficulty is going to be 4.
I never rooted for lying in my life, but this I'm rooting for.
Yeah, whatever. Wow.
That'll give me one more yellow, right?
This could give us 1 million credits on the black market.
That gives me one more yellow if I use a force point, right?
Are you using a force point for that?
Yeah.
Okay.
Let's see here. It's all going to be all successes and triumphs.
Yes!
Ooh, look at that. Whoa, baby.
Wow. Three successes.
Three successes and what is that? Two warnings, something like that. I mean, two threats.
That means he's never going to be your friend again. But we get our million credits.
Oh, no.
I'm a smuggler, so that looks viable for me.
No. For Luna will cold cock you.
He says, you know what? I think you're full of crap, but you did help me, so I'm going to give you this. But you are full of crap. So he hands one of them to you. He goes, let me just say something.
I just put a smirk.
If this gets in the wrong hands, you're not helping the galaxy. I just want to let you know.
I want to help the rebellion. Sure. I don't want to help.
I understand that, Lance.
I hate the Empire. You know that.
So he hands you guys one of them. And, of course, one of them is there for G-Bar to use. And, of course, he puts one away that he's going to take back to the Rebel Alliance.
I'm looking at it.
So, Trenton, are you drinking it?
Yes, sir. Yeah, I'll drink a little bit.
All right. So you take a couple of sips from it. And you just start to feel a little strange. It almost seems warm as it goes down your throat and into your body. And you can feel like a warmth come over you. And it's just, nothing's really outrageously happening in your body except a warmth. And you know this at G-Bar, his eyes are wide open. He's just watching you. As you're standing there, he's just watching you to see what's going to happen. And G-Bar kind of like responds looking at you.
Well, G-Bar is interested. Do you feel anything different? Do you feel more powerful?
I feel warm. I reach out with the force, like my move ability, just something to move it, you know, because, you know, up, down, around.
And you notice that when you do that, it seems as though it was easier to move whatever it was that you were moving.
Oh.
And G-Bar is kind of looking at you to find out if there was a difference. Do you feel anything different?
I did tell him that. I said it's very easy for me to do something with the Force.
Yes, exciting it is. G-Bar wants to see more. Drink more. And maybe you'll get even more powers.
Wait.
Drink at least half of the tube. G-Bar will want you.
I don't want to die either.
G-Bar won't let you die. G-Bar promises. G-Bar will monitor you.
What are you doing?
I stopped the vial. I close it. I think that's enough of a test. I think we understand.
G-Bar. G-Bar sad. G-Bar very sad.
Look, I'll give you the benefit of the doubt. I'll drink a little bit more, but that's it.
You notice that when you drink, you finish drinking about a quarter of the vial, you now have an extra force die whenever you use the force.
Oh, snap. I close the vial.
Okay.
I think we need to...
So there is 75% still left in that vial.
Wait, is that permanent?
Gosh.
You can't answer that. You gotta...
Can I put... I know there's no skill that's ventriloquist, but I wish there was.
Do I sense that? Do I sense his power in the force?
You saw him use the power much easier.
No, I'm saying, but like, do I sense that he has like a whole, like he's.
And Kenobi
definitely sense that there's definitely more power in that. Trenton, are you telling John and everybody how much more powerful you feel?
I tell John and G-Bar, I'm like, I'm definitely more powerful. I
You feel more connected with the Force.
Yes.
You feel that.
This time I grab, I reach out with the Force, and it comes in my hand. I whatever it is, a vial in the room, I flip it, turn it, look at it, and I just do it with incredible speed, back and forth.
Maybe this is what I need. Maybe this is what will help me to control myself.
Maybe it's good that we have another vial. Maybe it's good that we kept this vial.
I'm running.
Yes, yes. G-Bar wants to see more testing. Drink more. John, drink some.
I started drinking. I'm opening up like.
All right. Are you drinking half of it?
I drink the whole thing. I drink everything that's left in it.
Oh, snap.
I'm like, ah.
You feel this rush just go through your whole body. And just, it just, you feel like this hotness, not even a warmth, but you feel like a hotness, like you're about to explode, like there's a sun inside of you. And you could almost feel like these little life forms running through your veins. Your senses are just so keen now. And you feel like, one, you could feel the Force all about you. And it's almost like, remember in The Matrix, where Neo, he kind of like sees like everything to that degree. You're like seeing everything. Like, you could feel the Force within everything, except M1K3. You could just see that he's a hollow shell of a droid. but, yeah,
my
you have three extra Force dice when you use the power of the Force. So this guy's quickly monitoring your body. He injects you with a couple of things because he noticed that your body was going into like almost like a shock. So he kind of like helped you out there. He's just kind of like his eyes wide open. So what are you guys doing? Anything in particular?
Sell me on the market, please.
Well, I still need to get healed because I have a sprain. And I'm still looking for like a rush.
Yes, G-Bar will take care of your leg. Exciting things happening in front, and all you think about is yourself.
That's funny because that's what I see from my other two compadres, but that's okay that you say that. All I'm asking is for a leg fix. I'm not asking for any midichlorians.
As this process was going, I said, see, now you have the negative effects and the positive effects. Little is good, more is bad, obviously. And as far as thinking of ourselves, we're looking at the bigger picture, which is this falls in the wrong hands, it can be very deadly effects.
That's why I have one of them.
So you hear Vic say, G-Bar, finish up your testing and give me your results, and I'll head over to our next destination. And thank you for your help here.
Thank you.
Yes, yes, thank you, Vic. Thank you. G-Bar seen something today has never seen before. Yes, exciting. I'll take blood now from both of these, John and Trenton. Take blood, I will. Here we go. Yes, exciting.
My blood is all over the floor.
Take blood and fix his arm while you're at it.
So he's taking blood from you guys and stuff like that. He's doing tests. He starts to help Trenton. He's going to heal your arm. And he fixes your arm. He notices that it was all jacked up. And Lance, of course, he heals your strain.
But I also want a drug. Like, I need an upper, I tell him. I need an upper. Do you have one? I know you got to have one. Please. Upper? Deep down. But inside my head, I'm like loading this guy. For?
No, you'll be fine.
No, I'm tired. I didn't sleep all day.
Well, get some sleep. That's all you have to do to fix that.
Do you have any news instead until I get to sleep again?
I could give you something to keep you up, but yeah. It's very habit-forming. Do you want it?
Very what?
Habit-forming?
Yeah, sure, I'll take it. If I take it once, I'll be all right if I take it once.
Oh, yeah, sure, you'll be okay.
I tell him, give me the methadone with it, just in case I get into the habit.
All right, so he injects you with a stimulant, and that way you won't have your negative. And I need you to make a resilience check.
You're a drug addict now.
I just rolled that, and that is a failure. My addiction is coming for me, please. Give me more. I tell the insect man.
All right. So Vic tells all of you. He also says to. G-Bar. He says, "Thank you, G-Bar. You have always been a good friend to me, and always have helped the rebellion. And I thank you for that."
Yes! G-Bar, always happy to help the Rebellion. And Vic, you are always welcome here. Thank you for coming and allowing me to serve the Rebellion. I love helping.
Well, can you give me some more of those drugs before I leave? Since you love helping.
What do you mean? You need to leave. You're worrying me. You're strange. G-Bar does not like Lance. Lance, you need to leave.
Like I say to myself, the feeling is mutual.
All right.
But give me the drug anyway.
So Vic is saying, okay, I'm going to take this and I'm going to get a ship to the Rebel base. I know you guys have plans to do some other things. I'm going to meet you. I would like you guys to meet me at Yarvin. At the Rebel base called Yarvin 4. It is one of the moons at Yarvin, the planet.
Yes.
And that is where our base is at. So when you finish doing what it is that you need to do, come seek us. I would appreciate it. We can use your abilities. You guys have great talent. And I think if you could be a boon to the Rebellion. I really believe that. And Trenton, I'm proud of you. You make me proud. He walks over and he puts his hand on your shoulder. You know, I knew what I was doing. I was scared about it initially, but seeing who you are today and how you fight for the right things, I made the right choice. We could use you in the Rebellion. That I know. So hopefully I can see you at Yarvin. Yarvin 4, remember that. Hopefully our paths will cross again.
It will. I have my hand out too, as well. Thank you.
He kind of like just grabs your hand, shakes it really hard, because he doesn't really know how to give hugs and stuff like that. Kind of gives a smirk, nod of his head, and he turns around and he leaves. All right, what are you guys doing?
Before we leave, G-Bar, I do ask him one thing, one more question. G-Bar, I need some necessary equipment, and to the lightsaber, do you know where anywhere I could find it, or do you have it, if possible? Hi, Mitchell.
Lightsaber? there are some items here. That could possibly. I don't know how to build lightsabers. I have machinery. I'd be glad to help you find something if you like. You're more than welcome to take what you like as far as machinery if you like. Or your friend there, M1K3, who's took a lot of stuff already. I noticed in his backpack there. he might have some stuff you can use.
I ask him, I know you don't like me, but I mean well. Do you have any med kits or med packs that we can have?
No. Get out of here.
I'm taking something anyway.
Hey, what are you doing? Stay away.
I'm getting out of here. But I'm taking a med pack or two if I find them.
Wow. You just robbing it from him?
No, I'm smuggling it.
Smuggling. That's robbing. You're robbing it from him?
How many med packs do I can I take? I'll take two if I see them.
You find one.
Okay, I'll tell him I'm going to pay you back. Trust me. I'm telling you. I'm not as bad as you think.
G-Bar says one thing to you.
I leave.
Do you understand what I just said?
He's talking to me?
Yeah.
I don't know. Well, I didn't hear you.
That's because G-Bar didn't say it. I show it.
I understand. I go like that. I hate aliens.
He messed up two fingers, alien style.
I go like this to him with my other fingers, with my five fingers. Bye bye. All
right.
when he turns around, I steal the blood vials too. That.
Does he have a necessary
equipment? You're so evil, man. I'm dark side.
Does he have a necessary equipment?
You guys are hilarious. I love it. I love it, though. I love it. Okay. All right, so I take it you guys are leaving, right? Correct?
Yeah.
Yeah, does he have the necessary equipment, or do I have to go somewhere else?
You find some equipment that looks like you could use it. So, yes. There's some stuff there that you could utilize and put together. Absolutely.
Okay, I take that with.
All right. So, you guys, where are you heading to now? Are you heading back to your ship? Are you going to go to the coordinates that you have, those coordinates that you stole from that ship, that Imperial ship? Or are you going
to... Black Market. Let's go to Black Market for a second.
Do you want to go to an individual to sell and buy stuff? Is that what you want to do?
Let's sell my body.
Huh?
I said, let's sell my body.
Don't turn on the red light.
All right, so we'll do a cutscene. All right, you do know the chop shop, right? The chop shop, where the individual who's known as Prax, and he kind of like has his shop more like a mechanic's place, but you know that this place you can sell illegal things, buy illegal things and stuff like that. And as you enter it, of course, you see Prax himself there, right?
The devil.
Well, he's a Devorian merchant, right? That's what he's playing himself off as, but he is really just a black market seller, right? And you know this. So he's there. You're familiar with him. This guy, though, you really know that this guy with these long pointed ears, these sharp teeth, these two horns that he has on top of his head. He's someone that you've dealt with in the past on Tatooine, but he's someone that you can't fully trust. You can trust him because you've sold things to him before and stuff like that. But, you know that this is an individual that he's really out to make that buck, right? Over anything. His loyalties is to the famous credit, right? So what are you guys doing? He sees you. You notice that he's kind of like just looking at you. He kind of gives a sigh. What are you guys doing?
Take the lead, Lance.
Oh, I don't know. I wanted to ask you guys if you wanted me to find out how much this is worth and how much he's willing to possibly pay for it.
What? Mm-hmm. You're not going to know. You're not going to do that.
This vial.
You're not going to do that.
Well, all right, so I go to him and I say,
hey, why not?
How much? I mean, we need some supplies, mechanical supplies for, to fix our robot friend and maybe some supplies.
I know how much it's worth.
Fix our ship.
Yep.
Upgrade it, and just a question out of the blue, how much is midichlorian worth?
Oh my gosh. You notice he kind of like,
and he leans over. I didn't show him any, I'm just asking him.
And he leans over, and he looks like he's kind of bored, even though you said midichlorians, and he kind of like looks at you, and like he's almost like not even interested, and you hear him say,
yeah, what do you mean? Midichlorians.
Oh, you caught
you
that
got
one.
Got midichlorians?
No, my man, not that I have, but I might be able to get it. I just need to have an idea how much is like a good vial of it worth to you.
Look, don't waste my time.
I don't waste time.
You either have it or you don't. You know who I am.
I know I can get it.
I make money for people, and I make money. But don't waste my time. I don't play this deceptive crap, all right? You want to sell something to me, then sell it to me. If you don't, then go somewhere else. There's another shop down the street. Maybe they'll take care of you and your midichlorians.
I just have a question.
Right, what are you doing?
I tell him, listen, I know where I can get it. I already have it. But I don't have it on me because you know how this town is. So
all
I'm
right,
asking
so you're
you.
You're making a deception. Make your roll. It's the heart. It's hard. It's a hard roll because he's used to deception. So right off the bat, it's three purple.
Three purple.
I'm going to give you another setback die because of the scenario and that you came to him and that he has the cards, right? He's the guy who got the money. He's the guy who's going to that you need. You need him. He doesn't need you. All so right. Because of that, one black setback die. With your deception.
Okay. Not too good there. Actually, no good. A failure.
Yeah, so he kind of like looks at you.
Look, cut the crap. Right? You should know who you're messing with.
Do I still have the vial?
What's this
guy's
name?
I've been alive for a long period of time. I've been in this business longer than you know. So listen. You either want to sell me something or you don't. I don't care. If you think you could find someone else to sell it to, go ahead. But lying to me? You better just go somewhere else.
You're right. I'm lying. I'm sorry. What would this be worth to you? Do I still have it? What or somebody else?
Yeah, you have one.
What would this be worth?
What are you showing?
The Midichlorian.
And then his eyes open up.
Oh, now he is interested.
Because he sees it.
I stopped lying.
Now what are you saying this is, my friend?
1 million.
I told you before, midichlorians.
Good friend?
We want 1 million credits.
Best friend?
Okay, you can stop the lying now. I know I'm not your best friend. I just need to know what is this worth to you as so, one businessman to another.
So he grabs it. Takes a hold
I get in the way. Yep, I'm like,
you're looking at it. You're not grabbing anything yet.
Hey, I gotta know what it's worth. I gotta look at it under the microscope. I gotta analyze it. You think I'm gonna buy something I don't even know what it is just because it's fancy lights in a tube? Come on.
You can ask. What's the little guy's name? I forgot his name.
Jabbar.
You can ask Jabbar. He can be a witness that it is real and legit.
That is the truth. That's not a lie.
Jabbar? Come on, my friend. Jabbar, he's a happy-go-lucky guy who kind of like, you know, inhales too much of that, you know, medicine. I don't deal with Jabbar. You know who I deal with.
You said you're my friend, so
I deal with criminals. I deal with the underground. I deal with the dirt of the earth. And let me say something. If you come and bring this to me, you gotta be the dirt of the earth. Because that means that this stuff is illegal.
We have more illegal stuff too. But we want 1 million credits. I am incapable of lying. Here's where it came from. You can sell this to either the rebels who need it, who we just took it from.
Wow.
Or you can sell it to the Empire who would want even more money for it.
Oh, we also took it from.
We want 1 million credits.
What do you say, my good friend, like you just told me?
Let me see it. Sorry about that.
I'm showing it to you.
Let me see it.
Or you want to touch it?
I have to check to see if it's real.
And then I stand right there while you're looking at it.
Let me put it under the microscope here.
I stand right there too while you're looking at it under the microscope. And if you try anything funny, it won't be bode well.
All right, you notice that he kind of like turns around. He's kind of like puts it in this machine, kind of analyzing it. It's quite different than the machine. And that G-Bar has. It's not as sophisticated. And he's taking a look at it. He's looking down. He looks like he's pretty interested in what's happening. And then he takes it out of the machine and hands it back to you guys. And he says,
"Yeah, I might have somebody who's interested in that. I tell you what, now I ain't got no million credits, but I know that you have a vessel, right? How about a couple of upgrades, free of charge, for the exchange?"
"What kind of upgrades are we talking about?"
"Only the best. We're talking about maybe another weapon on your ship. Maybe some increased armor. I mean, a smuggler like you, I take it, probably could use some more protection. What do you say there, buddy? Friend?"
"Another weapon and increased armor. That's not $1 million worth in upgrades. $1 million credits worth in upgrades, excuse me."
"I'm sorry to say, you ain't gonna sell that for $1 million anywhere, right? You're hot. And let me say, not in the good-looking way. You're hot. This stuff, they're gonna be chasing your butt. So let's be honest, you need to get rid of this quick. I can do it. I have the connections."
"Is he lying?"
"I can do it for you. I gotta make a profit, my friend. So, do we have a deal?"
"Let me speak to my team, and I'll get right back to you."
"Sure, sure, my good friend. You go talk to your buddies. I'm gonna be right here, just watching."
"All right, guys. He's willing to upgrade, add another weapon, and increase our armor on our ship for this vial. And he'll get rid of it, which I'm sure he'll sell somewhere."
"I don't think it's worth it. We'll probably sell it to the hut. Maybe he'll give us more."
"Yeah. Yeah, I don't think that's enough of an upgrade on the ship. That's not enough. He needs
Those upgrades would be nice, but it's, I don't know, doesn't seem like it's the value of it."
"Nope.
I'd rather have one of these Jedis drink it."
"Yep, I think so too. I will refrain from selling it to you, Mr. Prax, as I was saying, because that's not enough. My good friend, like you say. So, we'll find another person and make a deal with them."
"We have to kill him. He's going to come after us."
"Well, my friend, that's all I can offer. So, I guess we're done here."
"Gonna come after us."
"No, I want to buy some weapons. Hold on, wait." Does he sell brass knuckles? What is those called? Vibro knuckles? "Yeah.
I got some brass knuckles here for you. What kind of credits you got, my friend?"
"I give him my stormtrooper gun. I will trade this illegal, highly deadly weapon for vibro knuckles."
"Oh, yes. Here you go, my friend. Enjoy these."
So you guys are exiting?
Yeah.
All right. So you go out of the shop.
As we go out, I go over to Faluna and I say, "So you're really struggling with things, aren't you?"
"Yes, I am."
"I want to apologize for the way I acted a while ago. I didn't know. I was thinking of myself. There's a lot of struggle within me as well."
"I understand. Us, the sensitive ones with the Force, we all have our own demons. And the truth is, my demon sometimes is quite powerful. But, Trenton, I care about John. Believe me when I say this. I care about him. You have to let me mold him and train him. It's the only way he's going to survive with the Force. I don't mean to insult you, Trenton, I really don't. But you're not skilled enough to train him. Let me mold him and train him how to use the Force, how to use a lightsaber, how to combat. I could even train you in how to combat with it. I could help you put it back together, your lightsaber. Let me do this. Let me use the Force in a good way. Let me do some good in my life. Trenton Lee, will you allow me to do this?
Do I sense that she's lying or she... She seems
sincere, if that's what you're asking. If you want to make a roll, you can make a roll. Yeah?
Nah, I'm not going to make a roll. I think she looks sincere. I get the, she's dead on. But can you do me a favor?
Sure.
Try to help out with us, please. I know you said you have, but
Richie.
You have to. Because... because...
every time she talks now, I'm going to put that picture up.
Because I just think that the guys, you know, would stop worrying. You know, we just want to do, we want to do right. I know we're kind of messed up, but we want to do right. That's all.
Trenton, the battle that you have, that I have, and John have, it's real. But I have to tell you this, you have no idea the battle that I'm facing. You have no idea. And with that, she kind of turns and starts to walk away. Are you guys now going to your ship, I take it? Yes?
Yeah.
All right. All right, so we're going to cut the scene here.
Rifles. But I don't think he was offering us enough to the ship.
And as you are traveling through the streets of Mos Eisley, I need all of you to make a perception roll.
Boom. I rolled a failure and two advantages.
Okay, so you don't see anything?
I failed.
I failed as well. See anything?
Two successes.
John, you made two successes? So you notice as you're traveling through the crowds, you see three figures in the distance.
It is
the Transdorians that you saw before, the bounty hunters, and they're there. And everyone, we're going to start combat because you notice, John, that they're raising their weapons. The main leader is raising his rifle. The other ones are raising their blaster pistols. You could react because you're the only one who noticed. Everybody else didn't notice. So we're going to look at your initiative and we'll look at their initiative, which I already rolled. Everybody rolled it just for those people viewing. Initiatives already rolled in advance. So the good news is, John, you only rolled three advances. So guess what? He goes first, and he's going to take a shot.
At Faluna.
Oh!
What the?
He fires his blaster rifle.
Oh, wow.
And you take 9, 10, 11 points of damage. What is your soak?
I would have been swaying.
11 minus 3.
Is 8.
You take 8 points of damage.
Just but a flesh wound.
Do I see his guts fall out?
That's right. A big weapon.
Next, before the other two, his partners, because he's the leader, you go, John, before them. What are you doing?
I'm gonna... How far are they?
They look like they're about 40 meters away.
That's like long range.
120 feet.
I don't. I know math's good. Medium, what is range. That? In, huh? Medium.
Medium range. Mm-hmm. What are you doing?
I have to get it to short range. So I start. This reminds me of like when we first did the runaway. Is there any kind of like cover? You know, like speeder that's there, like a, you know, land speeder, air something.
There's speeders all around and stuff if you wanted to get on one. But they're not that far away that if you run, you'll get there.
Yeah, but I want to save Trent. He's dying right now. He has like 3 hit points left.
Okay.
So I want to jump Trenton into cover.
I'm not dying.
I mean, you have how many points you have left?
We healed. I have. I only took 8.
That's he has it. 7 left. Holy.
7 left. I'm not dying.
Oh, okay.
Thank you. Thanks for the thumbs up.
That would have killed me. All right, I'm running. I'm running. Can I force speed run? I'm like, no, okay. I run closer.
Okay. So you're like running towards them through the crowd. You're pushing through people. Move out of the way. You're bumping into people, knocking them down. They're like, And so that's what you're doing this turn. And the other two guys are going to fire, and they're going to fire upon M1 and
Faluna.
And Trenton again.
Faluna!
Block with the lightsaber, Trenton.
Remember
this
your
one
training.
Is for M1. They miss.
Wow.
This one is for Trenton. Misses.
Oh.
Nice.
All
right. Now, new round. Because everybody else, you finally know, all of you, Lance, Trenton, M1K3, you realize you guys are getting shot at and you're in combat. So it goes back to the top, of course. It's those who rolled 1 success and 1 advantage, which happens to be the main character and M1. Oh, guess who goes first? Trenton, you go first because you got
3
success and 2 advantage. You literally go first. What are you doing, Trenton?
All right, I want to use the force, and I do have range, the 2 ranges, and I want you to do a force push on the bounty hunters.
On 1? You can activate on 1.
I know, the main guy. I'm going to knock his ass down.
All right. Make your roll.
Cool. 3 grand. Yeah, I like that. Excess. There you go.
Trenton, you reach out your hand, just use the force push. And you knock him, the leader. He feels this push on his chest, and he falls, caving in into like all of these merchants that are out. You hear just crashing of items falling on top of him, and he just drops to the ground, rifle dropping to adjacent to him.
That's all okay. I'm talking about.
Next. All right. Well, he goes. So he gets up, kind of like shuffles through the things, and he's looking for his rifle, and he picks up his rifle. That's his turn.
Okay, I'm at the same time. So when he picks up his rifle, he sees me right in front of him because I'm using a strain to run twice in front, right in front of him. So M1K3 is right in front of him with my brass knuckles. It's just like...
Right. Sounds good. All
that would have been cool in like a movie.
Yeah, the droid running real fast. Yeah.
Juan, you're on mute. What are you doing?
Should be the last one. I think you're before me.
We're just waiting for M1 to attack.
Wait, I get to attack? I don't know how far he was. Okay.
So immediately.
That's right. It takes two actions to get there. Yeah, so you're there. Alright, next is...
Right, if I strain, then I get to attack.
Oh, that's right. That's the point. Yeah, you're absolutely right. So you get to attack. That's correct.
My bad. Okay.
No. So he's standing there, rifle in his hands.
He's gonna get this loving.
Law.
Alright, does he add anything to difficulty? Or do I just roll my...
Let's see, nope, but he's pretty good at brawling, but nope.
Okay, he's about to get the fisting of a lifetime.
Of him. Oh, good.
Success.
You hit.
Success.
How much damage do you do?
I do one vicious, which adds one damage, so that's 4, 5, and the brass knuckles add one, so it's 6 damage, but I failed on the... That's critical. If I do one advantage, I roll on the critical chart, but I didn't make it.
Now, he does have a 6 soak.
Oh, so he takes 1 point of damage.
One point, so you hit him, and you just kind of like hear him growl. He feels it, and you see like a little bit of blood drip, green blood drip on his face. But you just kind of... He looks at you, and he's kind of like, there's almost like a smile on his, on the Trandoshian's face. Like, yes, he knows that this is going to be a challenge, that you're like going to be an opponent that is worthy of his skill. Because if you remember this race, they value a good combat, right? A good challenge. Yeah.
They hunt, right?
Exactly. So like when you hit him, he was happy that you're... Like, he knows you're powerful. He knows it. And he's just looking at you like, yes. So he's happy. All right, next. Next is,
I think it's John. Lance. I thought I was last.
Oh, yeah, John and then Lance.
Yeah,
you're right.
Right.
John has 3 and you have 2. Yep.
Now I'm in range.
You are.
And when I run, I slide. I'm like, and the sand kicks up. And then I'm like I come out of the sand, then I do my force power, and then I'm like, their brains falling, like coming out of their ears right now, because I can't believe you gave this to me. I have 4 force dice altogether, because I already had 1+3.
Are you gonna do like Thanos? Are you just gonna pull the planet down from everybody?
So I have, this is gonna be bad. This is gonna be disgusting.
I wanna see this.
So every pip is a strength.
Are you using those dark ones? Are you using them?
I am.
You are? Alright. Yes, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 4 of them.
And every success. So because it's because of one success, they all get it. So they're all in short range. So all of them take 1 strain. And then every other every other pip or whatever pow is a strain, so that's 1, that's 2, that's 3, and then you count the force pips. 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Is that 11 or I can't tell? That's
10.
It's 10. So one guy gets, so everybody else gets 1, and one guy gets 10, all 10.
That one guy, his brain, literally his head explodes. He's like,
oh man.
It explodes. And that Trandoshian is just like pieces of Trandoshians all over the place.
A
piece of it just falls on your head and just kind of drips there, the blood. And another one drops in pain on the floor. And the other one that's in front of M1K3, he's feeling pain too, but he's still there. All right.
We're gonna have to give Trenton the other bottle because someone's gonna control Steven.
Next, Lance, you go.
I think.
Yep, there's the leader that's next to M1, and also there's another hunter there.
The other guy. I'm taking partial cover and shooting at... No, I can't shoot at the leader because I can hit this guy, right?
Shoot it, man. Shoot it.
No, I'll shoot at... I'll take a shot at the leader.
Okay, you know if you miss, he's in combat with this guy.
I can take it. I'll take like 1 point of damage from your weapon.
I don't want to even do that, because I don't know how much he's going to Hassan you.
Help me, man. Help me kill him.
I'll take a shot, even though I don't really want to. So that's 3 green dice.
And that's 3 purple, because he's in combat with someone else.
The purple?
That's correct. 3 difficulty. That's a hard difficulty.
Aim, man. Aim twice, Juan.
Oh, 3. Oh, you know what? Yeah, let me just aim.
Okay, and there's 1 black because of the crowd. So you have 3 purple. And 1 setback die. So 3 difficulty, 1 setback die.
I'm gonna aim.
Alright, so I will give you a boost die.
Okay. Remember, I moved to take partial cover.
Correct. That was your move.
Okay. I don't even. Alright, I'm gonna roll. Hey, 2 success. Wow.
Yes.
Now, I do want to say you took a strain because you moved and went in cover, and then you fired. So you didn't have an aim. If you took an aim, that means that you took a strain. So that means that you take two strain because of doing that. But you hit.
Two success.
Your blaster. What's the damage on your blaster?
I think that's, I don't know. I think it's a six. I haven't used it in a while.
Six plus one because you did an extra success.
Seven. So seven.
His armor is six. He takes 1 point of damage.
It's tough, man.
Oh, yes. That
lizard skin.
He's a, he's a main one. Yeah, you notice that he's got hunter armor. He doesn't really protect that much. But he, his you could tell his brawn. This guy is pretty powerful. All right, next. We go back to the top. The first one is...
Trenton.
Trenton. Trenton, and then at the same time.
Luke Skywalker, come on.
What are you doing, Trenton?
All right, at this point...
on the Death Star.
Huh?
Put on the Death Star.
No, I'm going to... Knock him on the ground again.
What's Faluna doing? Nothing.
What she always does. She's laughing in the corner.
All right, I'm gonna go ahead and reach out with the force and and knock him down, so my adversaries, so my my friends could get advantages. Go back him down again. You force push. I got a light side.
Nice.
How many? What's difficulty? Two?
That's correct.
And one setback?
I'm going to say, yeah, one setback because of the crowds and M1K3s there. So that's going to make it a little bit more difficult.
Mm-hmm. Wow.
All right, you failed. M1K3.
Trent, you keep rolling green dice. Yeah, you gotta roll your green dice, man.
You already rolled the
good part. You gotta roll the good part.
You gotta roll three green dice with it.
Yeah.
So three green dice, two purple, and one black.
I'm sorry, I keep forgetting it. There you go. I got it.
Boom, success.
Not really, because he had three fails.
Yeah, I got three failed.
Which means that instead, M1K3, I need you to make a resilience roll.
Oh, no.
Otherwise, you get knocked down to the ground.
I probably had two dice.
Resilience? No, it's four.
Oh, wow, that's good.
It's my brawn.
Of course, it's difficulty two. You feel M1K3, you feel
and the advantage.
A gust of wind trying to knock you down, but you just hold yourself there. You're like, no.
And
but you realize that Trenton was the one who did that to you. Okay,
wait, since I rolled an advantage, can I give somebody an advantage?
Yeah, you could. Remember, you guys can utilize that anytime you want.
All right, whoever's after me.
All right. Next is, that was Trenton. All right, the same time, it's the leader with M1K3. So.
And I let him go first. I'm like, come on. I just, my robot hands. I'm like,
All right, he's gonna just brawl you.
Yeah, let's do it. Watch him whip my butt. He's been throwing me around. Like a ragdoll.
Fail. I sense a massive failure.
All right. What? That's two difficulty.
And I sense.
Brawl. Anyone who's brawling me, it's purple. Three purple. Right. I mean, three black. Sorry. Three black.
How many?
Three black.
He's got a roll of despair.
Upgraded. Right. Two black if you're shooting me. Three black if you're in melee.
That's awesome. Roll. Here we go.
Or failure.
Oh, he tries to hit you with his fist, and he just misses. You just kind of like, it bounces off your armor. Kink! The droid that you are.
That's right.
Cheesy as you are. All
right,
you go.
I'm showing how it's done. I'm just doing the robot. Like
just show him, man. M1K3, show him how it's done.
What's that? I'm just like...
Do you remember the punch out robots? or you just press the back and their arms go out.
Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah.
I'm aiming for this one, so you could, I guess, give me a strength.
Yeah, sure.
Oh, knock him out, Dad! Knock him out!
Wow. Wow, tremendous.
Nice.
All right, how much damage did you do?
So it's a plus one because of the... So my strength is a 4, plus one because I'm wearing the glove. Plus one, the glove gives me vicious. And then it's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So 11 points of damage.
Minus plus 6
is 5.
So 5 points damage. Plus, because I rolled an advantage with the vibro glove, vibro knuckles, I get to roll under the
critical
chart.
All right.
So I'm gonna roll 100. I'm gonna roll 100.
Let's look at.
How about a 97?
Let me pull up that chart and see the massive damage. Okay, oh, roll snap. Under the critical chart.
26.
26. Feels discouraging wound. Flip one light destiny to dark. Oh, I get another dark, but you guys already wasted all the dark.
Wait, isn't it the opposite?
No, well, it's a critical, so it's discouraging wound. Flip one light destiny to dark. So
wouldn't that be if you hit me?
Yeah, so now you get a light side point.
Yeah, give us a light side. That's how I did it. How good I punched him. I was like, aha! Light side point.
Nice. That's going.
You hit him so hard that the force got him involved.
Like Sonic the Hedgehog in 2 rings.
What the heck is that, man? That doesn't even make sense. All right, whatever. It's good. It's cool. Thematic. You strike him and the force gets involved. You feel like, yes.
Love me.
Oh, okay, here we go. All right, next. That was M1K3.
Next John.
Is John. What are you doing?
There's two bad guys left, right? The main boss and the. So I'm taking a strain, right? So I'm taking one strain because I can actually do this maneuver. As a maneuver, I can do this attack as a maneuver. So I'm doing it as my attack action, as a maneuver, and as a maneuver, and I'm doing it to that other guy. I'm leaving the boss with MK right now. I'm just. And I just put my hand towards that guy and just blast him away. So remember, every pip is basically
an extra point of damage.
Yeah. Point of damage.
Oh, man.
So you
have to. Oh, wow. Wow.
Oof. What?
When he has to fight the team, he's going to destroy us.
I can't. Hey, it won't let me. Okay, hold on. Wait.
Trent, do you see this?
Forget it. What, you don't even have to. Triumph and everything else. What the heck?
Oh my gosh, that's a lot of dark side points he's drinking.
Are you using the dark side points?
I don't even have to because I think.
I don't think I have to.
I think if I just use the light side, it still goes down, right?
So the other Trandoshan hunter, his head also, he starts to feel the pain as you're reaching out to him with the force. And his head explodes also. Pieces of that their meat and their brain falls all over the place. And the other one takes some wounds, the leader. But he looks like he's still in the fight. Next.
Help me, Lance.
I'm taking a shot at that leader. I should be stable now, so I'm aiming at him.
Okay. You'll get a bonus for that. You don't have to strain. So remember, it's difficulty 2.
That's plus wait, that's
a setback die for the crowd.
It's a black.
You get a boost die because you're aiming.
Alright, I'm aiming and shooting, and here goes a shot. 2 failures and 4 advantages.
Your blaster pistol, and you miss. Alright, next.
I'm giving the advantages to Mike.
Thank you.
Go back to the top. Trenton, you go first.
All right, since my lightsaber is down, I want to force pike it. I take a strain, frenzied attack. Give me a second here, sorry. All right, here we go. So I take it 2 difficulty and 1 setback still, or no?
Correct. In melee, it's always 2 difficulty. So.
Okay, here we go. Come on, gentlemen. I miss.
You swing your force pike and you miss him. It's his turn.
He's gonna murder me.
K1, K3, and him. And he's attacking.
He's gonna miss again. With a bunch of failures.
Wait, add 3 black die.
Steven, you better chill out with the force, man. You got like...
I didn't use dark sides that time.
I know, but the one before, man.
Oh, he bounces off your armor again. He claws you. Thank and you it God. Just bounces right off your armor. Clink!
I know when he hits me, it's going to be like 12 damage.
All right, you go.
Okay.
Remember, I gave you advantages.
Oh, yes. Thank you.
Who's died, baby?
I use Juan's advantage, and I aim, and then I club him in the face. Club assist!
Oh, that's good.
So each advantage adds a plus 10% on the critical hit, on the critical chart. So he takes 7 points damage.
All right, take minus 6, he takes 1.
So he has 8 damage. 8 1, or 9, I think.
3, 4. So plus 50% because he already got hit on the chart. So it's 105. 108, sorry.
108, yeah.
108. Oof. Horrific injury.
Awesome.
Random characteristics dropped by 1 till healed. I mean, this guy. All right. We're going to drop his agility. You strike him across the thigh, injuring him where he can't even travel now. He's going to slow down.
Wow.
It looks like he's slower now. Blood is dripping from that wound on his thigh. It almost seems as though you might have hit an artery. I mean, combined with all the damage he's been taking, he looks like he's in bad condition. But M1K3, you notice because you're there face to face, you would assume that there would be terror in his eyes. But there's a smile on his face, and there's a glint in his eye, as if, yes, this is the way I must die. Next.
It's a true John. Warrior.
Next is...
John.
Yep. John. Tatsuo!
I just put my hand next to his head and I'm like, drop your weapon. I end up like them. So I'm using coercion to use what I've done to the other two guys.
Okay.
To make him give up.
All right. Make that roll. It's going to be difficulty of 3. Plus, I'm going to give an extra setback die. And the reason for that is because he is a Transdoshian and he does not want to die like that. He's looking at M1K3 and he wants to die an honorable death. So that's going to kind of resist trying to give up. So go ahead, make your roll.
Okay. So, because
so
of his
heart, that's 3 purples. You know,
3 plus the black die.
Die.
I'm using another strain point, and I'm using intense focus to increase my skill, and then because I have influence as control, I get to use forced pips as successes.
That's crazy.
So that's 4 successes. Yeah, it's pretty bad. Never give me this much power.
He's like fighting it, and you're like telling him. And he kind of like puts his hands down, reluctant in some ways.
Now tell us who sent you.
And he stops combating. And when you say that, when you ask that question, he almost seems as though he's fighting to resisting to even say to answer that question.
You know. She knows.
And he looks at Feluna. And Feluna kind of like looks at him. Raises her head.
Hey, mind powers.
She's gonna kill him.
She knows who sent me. us. You think I was a challenge? You have no idea. You need to ask her. Who's hunting her down? I'm not a threat. But that individual is.
Just force choking him.
And you notice that he puts his hand up against his throat. And it seems as though he's struggling to speak and breathe.
I'm like, Trenton, I'm not doing this. It's not and me, I promise.
He drops to the ground, dead.
Oh, wow.
What are you guys doing?
Taking his blasters.
Taking blasters?
Blaster.
Oh, okay.
Yeah. What the?
It's a blaster rifle.
I look at Faluna and I'm like, who sent them?
I don't know.
Come on. You gotta stop being honest.
I'm struggling with some things, Lance. You don't understand.
You can't tell me who sent them.
Sith Lord.
I can't.
I'm done. I'm done with this.
But I'm looking in the pockets that have the keys to their ship.
What? Oh, you're doing what?
Keys to their ship.
Keys to their ship. And that ship that they got.
John. Yes. Tell them they must spring. They must go to the coordinates that you have retrieved. Yes. Because you know. You must come to me, John. And you see an image, John, in your head. This shadowy figure come from the darkness. A face, red, with black tattoos. Red, piercing eyes.
Oh, Darth Maul.
And it's calling to you. And it's almost as if you can't resist. And this is where we end this mission, this adventure. Thank you for joining us in Out of Character RPG. I hope that you guys can subscribe, hit that notification bell. Come on, guys. You got to see it's some exciting things happening. You got to come to the next. You got to see the next episode. Something is happening. Something that's big. You don't want to miss it. Who's calling John? Who is calling Jed? Come on, guys. Come join us. You don't want to miss this. Some exciting stuff happening. Thank you for being with us. M1K3. That's all right.
There's a 10 more experience points.
Bye, guys. See ya.
10 experience.